Hello everybody! Today's lesson will be poetry. The title of our poem today is Day, and it is written by the poet Cecil Spring Rice. Cecil Spring Rice. Now let's discuss the objectives of this lesson. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to. Number 1. Identify any regular poem. Number 2. Analyze its component parts. Number 3. You will be able to predict its theme or author's message. And finally, you will be able to identify the figures of speech and the sound devices found in it. Now, let's know some background information about the poet. Cecil Spring Rice was born in 1859 and died 1918. Spring Rice studied at Oxford, England. He worked at several jobs in the Foreign Office and was also the ambassador to Iran and the United States along with his political work. Rice was also a poet. His most famous poem is I Vow to Thee My Country. It is a patriotic poem and today is still sung at Rugby World Cup games. Besides his patriotic poetry, Spring Rice also took the time to write poems for children. His children's poetry was written to help them appreciate the wonderful world around them. Dear students, do you have any idea about the elements of nature? Certainly, you have studied them in science. In this poem, we are going to deal with four elements of nature. Number 1, the sea. Number 2, the rain. Number 3, the air. And number 4, the sun. Let's start reading the poem together. The title is Day. I'm busy, said the sea. I'm busy, think of me. Making continents to be. I'm busy, said the sea. I'm busy, said the rain. When I fall, it is not in vain. Wait, and you'll see the grain. I'm busy, said the rain. I'm busy, said the air. Blowing here and blowing there. Up and down and everywhere. I'm busy, said the air. I'm busy, said the sun. All my planets, every one. No, my work is never done. I'm busy, said the sun. Sea and rain and air and sun. Here is a fellow, toiler one, whose task will soon be done. Regarding the genre of this poem, it is a lyrical, regular poem. What about its form and structure? It's a lyrical, regular poem of 19 lines, written in 5 stanzas. It has a regular rhyme scheme and a regular rhythm. Shifting to the setting of this poem. The time of this poem is an unspecified time. And also the place is an unspecified place. Our essential question today is, what is the difference between the work of the elements of nature and the work of man? Who is the speaker in this poem? Actually, we have 5 speakers. The sea, the rain, the air, the sun, and man. What about the tone of this poem? This poem has a joyful, merry, happy, and cheerful tone. Now, let's have some background information about the poem itself. The elements of nature are very important to man. They are the constituents of the environment surrounding him. Without the elements of nature, humans cannot live on earth because they provide him with breath, food, and water. Cecil Spring Rice knows the importance of the elements of nature very well, and he documented it in his poem Day. The sea says that he is busy making the continent in which we live, and he asks the reader to think in him and his great work. The rain also says that she is busy helping the plants to grow. The air says that he is busy moving all the time. Why? To help us to breathe and to cool the weather for us. The sun says that she is busy taking care of all her planets and providing them with the life and warmth. Finally, man speaks to all of them, saying that he also works hard, but his work will end by his death, while the work of the elements of nature will never end. Now, dears, let's draw a very concise comparison between the work of the elements of nature and the work of humans or man. Now we are comparing the work of the elements of nature to the work of man. Number one, the work of the elements of nature is eternal. It never ends. Whereas the work of man will end by his death. Number two, the work of the elements of nature is more important than the work of man, while the work of man is less important than the work of the elements of nature. Let's start discussing the figures of speech in this poem together. We have a lot of personifications in this poem. Personification number one, I'm busy, said the sea. Here, the poet personifies the sea as a human who is busy and who can speak. The second personification is, I'm busy, said the rain. Here, the poet personifies the rain as a human who is busy and who can speak. The third personification found in this poem is, I'm busy, said the air. Here, the poet personifies the air as a human who is busy and who can speak. The fourth personification in the poem Day is, I'm busy, said the sun. Here, the poet personifies the sun as a human who is busy and who can speak. We have a contrast in the sentence, blowing here and blowing there. As the poet brings the two opposite words, here and there, together to clarify the meaning. Another contrast is found in the sentence, up and down and everywhere. Here, the poet brings the two opposite words, up and down, together. Why? To clarify the meaning. Now, dears, let's discuss the sound devices found in this poem. First, alliteration. Do you remember alliteration? Alliteration is the repetition of the first consonant sound, as in said C, SS, wait, well, said sun, C, sun. Moving to the rhyme scheme, I told you before that this poem is a regular one, so it has a regular rhyme scheme. A. B, 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 C, 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 D, 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 E, E, E. Also, we have a lot of rhyming words, such as C, me, B, C, rain, vein, grain, rain, sun, one, done, sun, and finally, sun, one, done. Repetition is another sound device used by the poet here. The phrase I'm busy is repeated 3 times in stanza 1. The phrase I'm busy, said the rain, is repeated 2 times in stanza 2. The phrase I'm busy is repeated 2 times in stanza 3. The word blowing is repeated 2 times in stanza 3. Also, the phrase I'm busy is repeated 2 times in stanza 4. The pronoun I is repeated 2 times in stanza 4. And the word and is repeated 3 times in the first line of stanza 5. Dear students, this is the end of today's lesson. I hope that every one of you has enjoyed the lesson. I have enjoyed the lesson with you. Thank you for listening and for paying attention, and see you in another lesson, inshallah.